Nothing is more important than being able to connect with people virtually. Today, I'm going to show you how to host a great Zoom meeting right from your phone. Let's get into it. So the first thing you're going to need to do is open up your Zoom app and get logged in. Now, Zoom makes it super simple to make decisions on how you want to host your meeting. But if you want to start a meeting right away, you simply click the New Meeting button here in the top left. You can decide whether you want your video on or off. I typically start with it on. And then you start your meeting. You can see how easy it is to actually start your meeting. Let's look at some of the key features and functions. Notice at the bottom that you can mute, stop video, share, or invite other people to join your meeting. So let's go through these real quick. Mute, pretty simple. If you don't want people to hear what you're saying, you mute it. If you don't want to have video recorded, you hit stop video and it'll show a little picture that you have preloaded. Share is really a great feature and it allows you to share images, videos, documents right from your phone. And then for participants, this is the best way to invite people to your Zoom meeting. So at the bottom here, you'll note you can simply invite and you can send the invite via Messenger, text message, Gmail. There's so many different ways that you can send this out. You can even copy the URL and post it to a Facebook group, to a WhatsApp channel. You can post this anywhere. It's super easy for people to join your meeting. They simply click the link and they join in. If you did set up a password, you're going to want to make sure that you give them the password. They might also be put into a waiting room if you have that option selected, in which case you simply accept them into the meeting. So you can see this notification that Joanna has just accepted the invite, but she's now in the waiting room. I'm simply going to admit her to let her in. You can see that Joanna has just entered the meeting, but the screen is all black. There's two reasons for this. A, she hasn't selected to have her video on. And B, you'll see that at the bottom, there are three little dots. If you swipe to the right, that'll give you an image of all the people that are currently in the meeting. And you can keep swiping right to see more and more people. So now Joanna's in the meeting. She can engage with me. She can listen to me. And I can wash, rinse, and repeat this method for as many people that want to join. You might say, Mark, well, what about when the video is done? What do I do then? Super simple. You're going to swipe left and then simply hit the end button at the top right. Now, you can either leave the meeting, which just removes yourself, or you can end the meeting, which will knock everyone out. Keep that in mind when you're choosing your leave option. A lot of times, your meetings are not going to be happening right now, but they're happening in the future. Let me show you how you can easily schedule a meeting to happen then in the future. So at your main screen here, we first selected new meeting. This time, we're going to select schedule. And you can type in whatever you want for the name of your meeting. You select your date. You select your time. I recommend selecting an end time as well so that your guests know how long this meeting is going to take. Of course, time zone. Is this a repeating meeting? Do you want to have a password enabled? Do you want your video on? Do you want your participants' video on? It's that easy. Let's look at the advanced options also. Enable waiting room means that your guest will not automatically come into the meeting. They're going to go into a side room. Once you've allowed them, then they can join the actual meeting itself. You'll notice that I have mine set to automatically record. Now, if you are looking to record from your phone, you can only do it on the cloud, which requires a paid subscription to Zoom. If you're having your Zoom call on your desktop, you can record it right to your computer. So that's something to consider. If you might not be at the Zoom meeting, you can also select alternative hosts, which is another convenient feature. I would strongly recommend that you use this final option and automatically add the Zoom meetings to your calendar. It's going to be super easy for you to stay organized that way. Now that we've selected all our features, we have the option of inviting guests. Now, how do we want to do that? You can see here that you can either use Gmail, email, Yahoo Mail, or you can just click out of that. And down here, you see the option of add invitees. And again, you have a ton of different ways to invite people. You can even use this copy the clipboard, which I love. When you copy to clipboard, you simply paste it wherever you want people to come from, whether that's your Facebook group, your WhatsApp message board, wherever. Listen, it's that simple to start your Zoom meeting. I'm really excited to hear your questions and hear about your success, so type it in the comments below. A quick side tip before you get started, I would recommend that you have headphones and a mic nearby in order to avoid potential feedback. Sometimes this happens, sometimes it doesn't. Just make sure to have those devices nearby in case they're needed. Now you have all the tools you need to host an awesome Zoom meeting right from your phone. Consider subscribing to the channel for more great content and write your comments below so that I can answer them and make sure that your meeting goes off without a hitch. Have a great day. Peace.